Papillon. That is the aircraft that you see on the takeoff roll right on your right towards the north. He is airborne.
this maneuver, they will approach show center at 200 feet and nearly Mach 1.0, or just under 750 miles per hour. You may notice the white vapor coming off the aircraft, indicating that it is close to the speed of sound. Let's see if we can get Trash Cat on the radio to see how fast they're... The next maneuver is the vertical pirouette. It's approaching show center at 400 miles per hour. Grouse the Trash Cat will pull the aircraft into the vertical and roll the canopy towards the crowd. After a negative 2G pushover to wings level, the aircrew will pull the nose of the aircraft up and yaw the aircraft without ever taking the canopy off the crowd. This ability to rapidly swap nose and tail position gives the Super Hornet a distinct advantage in the air-to-air arena. Ladies and gentlemen, from the left, the square loop. Inverted. It takes a lot of concentration to fly upside down while hanging from the straps of your harness. Notice how quiet the aircraft is as it passes in front of you at over 500 miles per hour. Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the Super Hornet inverted Whisper Pass. Trash Cat are now setting up for the High Alpha Pass. This maneuver will show you the incredible slow speed handling characteristics of the Super Hornet. Few other aircraft in the world will attempt to maneuver at such slow speed and high angle attack. However, the Super Hornet's two digital flight control computers allow it to remain completely controllable while flying at less than 120 miles per hour. In some dogfights, the ability to fly slowly is more important than being able to fly fast, since this allows the Super Hornet to get behind the other aircraft and employ. maneuver from the split S. Krause and Trash Can perform a pitch rate demonstration maneuver to showcase the Super Hornets' excellent pitch authority with a 90 and then a 40 degree turn. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're enjoying the show so far, make some noise for Krause and Trash Can. The job of the naval aviator is not complete until their aircraft is back aboard its floating home. Of a normal runway, carrier aviators must touch down between four wires stretched across the deck of a ship. To do this, we'll use an optical landing system commonly referred to as the ball. During the final portion of the approach, the air crew and the landing signal officer, known as paddles, will work together.
And talk to you.
So our exhibit booth is located in the back right corner. We have virtual reality going on over there in an F-35 flight simulator. If you want to come and try it out, all you have to do is simply register on the desk on the right.
So in your role as a recruiter, tell us what...
And, ultimately, does the Air Force solve those problems? Is the way I kind of figure out the situation.
Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause.
Thank you very much, Brittany. Who's having a good time this afternoon? Ready for some more air show? In just a few moments, we're going to be going back to the days of World War II to bring you the B-25 Mitchell, nicknamed Panchito. And I'm looking forward to telling you the story of the B-25, as well as Panchito specifically. While we're waiting, they're getting warmed up in the performer parking area off to your right. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank some more sponsors.
Maintenance team and our maintenance professional.